A lot of couples don't tend to agree on interior design. The way to get around that is to hire us. Hi, I'm Shanie.
And I'm Tony.
And we're the owners of His and Hers Renovations and Interiors.
And KWM Property. We also happen to be married.
And parents to our toddler River. In 2016, we brought our first home after 7 years of saving and living with Tony's mum. We took on a huge project and we had very little money, so we learnt the skills we needed to do the renovations ourselves on YouTube. After posting pictures of our finished home to Instagram and showing some friends who invested in property, we soon started our business and we've been building our brand since then, including recently buying our decorating business, KWM Property, to keep as much of our projects in-house. I love all things interior design: colour, texture, fabric, wallpaper, furniture and styling. That's what gets me excited.
And I'm obsessed with DIY. I really enjoy getting my hands dirty and working with a wider team on site, all while we try and figure out how to make Shanie's vision come to life.
Hi.
Yeah?
The handle's at the wrong direction, so I'm 100% gonna go through this wall.
And then move the handle.
How the bloody hell do you do that?
We work in property sourcing, project management, as well as interior design and renovation.
With the cost of living crisis, we're always keen to work with every budget, and we love to encourage our clients to donate what they no longer need or repurpose what they already have, as we really care about the environment and sustainability. Being self-taught, well, actually YouTube taught, we're always learning and growing with every project that we take on.
And even though we're already doing the job, I've still signed up to Interior Design School because there's always more to learn.
Buying and renovating properties can be completely overwhelming for some, but we thrive on it. And our goal is to help other people do the same whilst creating the perfect dream home or ideal investment.
The way we tend to come up with inspiration for each individual project is to really look at the client and see what they're already interested in, what's their passions, you know, what does their fashion look like? Do they wear colour?
We tend to kind of find out exactly what they're looking for within their home. I think that's the most important thing, is what is it you want to get out of your home? Is it somewhere to, you know, watch movies or somewhere to entertain? And then we go from there and we just find our inspiration off of that.
Yep. In the current climate, people are moving less and renovating more. Why move and pay all of that stamp duty when you can just stay put and plough your money into the home that you've already got? Let's go and check out how to make more space for this family in Southeast London. So when it comes to bathroom design, you can go super minimalist or super maximalist. And with this bathroom, we definitely went for the max. We kicked off with sorting out this window. Before, it was tiny, it didn't let in enough light. We decided to make the window much bigger to let in more light and just added a really simple satin glaze. Now, you might recognize this print. It's a very famous print by David Hockney. And this was actually the inspiration for this entire bathroom. The client already owned the print and she loved the color combinations, particularly the coral. So that was what informed the rest of the decisions in this room. The colours on the wallpaper, the colours on the tile, the combination of the pink and the coral, all stemmed from this inspiration. But this is the area where the true planning came into action. We actually built out a false wall so that we could create these three shelves, especially for things like diffusers and vases and candles and all of the things that make the client feel like she's in a hotel rather than her home.
So, first thing is, when we're hanging our pictures, we will always need a spirit level. Make sure that we're getting everything completely, as you can see, square and plumb. Now, most people use command strips, which is a really good idea because they don't leave any damage when you take them off the walls or anything like that. But if you are using screws and nails, sometimes you may have to use masking tape to tape the back of your picture to then get the idea of where your screw holes are. You can then hold that up onto the wall with a level, drill where you need to drill, and hang.
I wanted to become an interior designer at the point where I'd finished designing my own home and I had like itchy fingers to do more and more and more. It was just something about turning something from ugly and derelict and quite frankly disgusting and making it this like beautiful home where we could entertain our friends and have fun and just relax after a long day.
So my favorite project that we've worked on has to be a project we've done for a family where we had to figure out a way of getting a 140 kilogram stone resin bath up three flights of stairs into a loft. It was a head scratcher, but we got there in the end.
So what's important to me is that we either encourage our clients to give away things to more needy people, upcycle things that they already have. We're in the land of fast fashion and fast turnover when it comes to homeware as well. And although, you know, it is nice to have shiny new things in your home, I also think there is some really beautiful things out there. I think if I was to design a property anywhere in the world, I would probably like to do something in New York City. I really like the idea. Was that going to be your answer? Was it really? Yeah. I really like the idea of doing like a New York City loft apartment. Is it really?
Yeah, it was. It's just such a nice area. Getting just good lighting, but also being in the city.